Why'd you volunteer for this mission anyway?
Did you see Princess? She totally stood up to Captain. Of course I'm gonna go.
Well, I hope we don't die.
God, did you see Princess's hair?
This is Dr. Spacek. I'm making this video in case something happens to me. It's day one after the outbreak, and things aren't looking good for mankind. It's day five, and I am working on a kind of vaccine. It may be able to help some of these poor people. I have tested on a former assistant of mine already, and the results seem promising. Here, let me show you. This was not possible before the vaccine. It's day 16. Yesterday we had an incident. My instinct seemed to be getting angry with me, and she bit me. And I've already taken the vaccine, but I have no idea if it'll work. Day 19. I feel lightheaded today. Aside from the vaccine we have been working on, an acid-based liquid, which I hold in my hands, that attacks zombie flesh on contact. I hope it works. This is day 22 or 23, I'm not even sure anymore. I feel funny. I hate this virus.
What do you think happened to that guy? I don't know, but maybe this is the antidote. Maybe he's around and maybe he can help us. Yeah, we'll try to find him. That would be great. What? Oh my god.
Oh, man. That vaccine might have just been our savior. We might have had a chance if she'd have made it back to camp in time. But as luck would have it, Princess ran straight into the arms of the one creature on Earth that could have kept her away.
I shall call you up, invest a dime, and you say you belong to me. It leaves my mind. Imagine how the world could be so very fine, so happy together.
Tell Captain. But now I know they have beating hearts, and yours beats for me. I'll keep you. I have to go say goodbye to Captain.
Princess didn't know she was being followed. She didn't know that she was leading the enemy directly to the gates of our hidden base. But she was. And that zombie spy brought the news back to her leader before the grits went cold in the griddle.